हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल सी एन इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन ऑफ डिटर्मिनेंट इन विच द एलिमेंट्स आर इन फैक्टोरियल फॉर्म. हाउ वी सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम्स? दिस प्रॉब्लम आर मेनली एमसीक्यू एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर सीबीएसई, आईसीएसई बोर्ड एग्जाम्स, ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर जेई मेन एंड वेरियस कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जामिनेशंस. सो ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, but how we can solve it. Okay, and for quick solution we need a result. So first one, we will see a result. What is the result? Result is, if we find a determinant like n factorial n plus 1, n plus 2 factorial n plus 1, n plus 2 n plus 3, n plus 2, n plus 3, n plus 4. Okay, if the elements are in such a arrangement, then the value of this determinant is simply equal to 2 into product of elements, product of elements of first row or the first column, or the first column. You may take either first row or first column. If you see the every element of first row is equal to corresponding element of first column, so first row and first column is same. Similarly, second row and second column are same, and third row is similar to the third column. So we can say it is a symmetric matrix. Okay, this one also, notice that this is the symmetric matrix. That means if we find A transpose, then we get simply equal to the matrix. So this is the symmetric, this is the determinant of symmetric matrix. Determinant of symmetric matrix. Okay. Now, using this result, we can write, if we have to write the value of determinant factorial 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 5, then simply we write it is equal to 2 into product of first, product of element of first row. So it is factorial 1, factorial 2, factorial 3. Either we can take the element of first row or the element of first column, both are same. So finally we get it is 2, 1 factorial 2 is again 2, and 3 is 6, so it is equal to 24, or we can say it is factorial 4. Okay, so this is the result. Similarly, we can use the other results, like the other result, like second result is, if we have given factorial 10, factorial 11, factorial 12, factorial 11, 12, 13, 12, 13, 14. Okay. Then the value is 2 into product of elements of first row or first column, or and it is 10, 11 and 12. So this is the answer. In this way, we can find every determinant of this form if the pattern of element is similar to the given in the result. Okay, the pattern is what? N, n plus 1, n plus 2, then the second row starts from n plus 1. Okay, diagonally start n plus 1, then n plus 2, n plus 3, again it is n plus 2, n plus 3 and n plus 4, and definitely it is a symmetric matrix. Then if the pattern of the elements is similar to this pattern, then we are definitely evaluate the determinant value very quickly. So for a quick evaluation, we have to need this result. So this is a very important result and must be remembered. Okay, how we can prove it? A very simple proof of this type of determinant. Look at the proof of this first determinant. Okay, let's prove it. Okay, how we prove? Very similar, very simple work is here. Write the first row as it is, 1, 2, 3. Now the second row we can write. For this we have to need a result of factorial n. We can write factorial n equal to n factorial n minus 1. Okay, and it is very important result of factorial. We can write every factorial element by this way. So factorial 2 can be written as what? 2 factorial 1. Factorial 3 is what? 3 factorial 2, like this. Okay, so factorial 2 is 2 factorial 1, it is 3 factorial 2, and it is 4 factorial 3. The third row element is 3 factorial 2. 3 factorial 2, again we can write 3 as what? 3 into 2 into factorial 1. Okay, so we write here 3 into 2 factorial 1. The 4 is 4 into 3 factorial 2, and 5 is 5 4 factorial 3. Okay, so the determinant now is in this form, and in first column factorial 1 is column, in second factorial 2 common, and in third column factorial 3 is common. So we can take the common element factorial 1, factorial 2, factorial 3. So the determinant have elements simply 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, and it is 6, 12, and 20. Okay, clear? Now we have a simple operation for the quick evaluation. 1, 2, 3. Apply the column operation. C2 is replaced by C2 minus C1, and C3 replaced by C3 minus C2. Okay, so we get the determinant. First one is 1, first one remain 1 because first column is as it is, and second and third column are operated by new columns. Okay, so it is 0, again it is 0, it is 2, it is 1, and it is again 1. This one is 6, it is 12 minus 6, that means 6, and this one is 20 minus 12, that means 8. Okay, now if we solve this simple determinant, then we taking corresponding to the first row, we have only non-zero element 1, and corresponding to 1 the minor is 8 minus 6. So it is equal to factorial 1, factorial 2, factorial 3, 8 minus 6. So simply it is equal to 2 into factorial 1, factorial 2 into factorial 3. And what is this? This one is elements of first row definitely, or we can say first column. So it is 2 into product of elements of first row, or we can say first column. Okay, so this is the simple proof of the result. Now using this result, how we can prove the above question? Okay, let us see. Okay, how we can find the value of this determinant? First one, we need some elementary operations. Let proceed it. Okay, this one is equivalently equal to determinant of 1, 2, 3, the second row is 2 factorial 2, 3 factorial 3, 4 factorial 4. Now the third row, we can write this third row is as 3 factorial 2, 4 factorial 3, and it is 5 factorial 4. Okay. We use the property of factorial n is equal to n into factorial n minus 1. So definitely we can write factorial 3 as 3 factorial 2, factorial 4 as 4 factorial 3, and so on. Okay. Now this one is simply equal to factorial 1, factorial 2, and factorial 3. We apply elementary operation R2, first apply R3, so R3 is replaced by R3 minus R2. So we find 2 root 2, 3 factorial 3, 4 factorial 4, and this one, the R3, the element of R3 is, when subtract 2 factorial 2 in 3 factorial 2, we get simply factorial 2. It is simply factorial 3, and it is simply factorial 4. Okay. Now the another operation that we apply is factorial 1, 2, 3. First row remains same. Now second row is replaced by R2 plus R3. Okay, so the new determinant is 1, 2, 3, then 2. R2 is replaced by R2 plus R3. Okay, so when we add 2 factorial 2 with factorial 2, we get 3 factorial 2. Again, it is 4 factorial 3, and it is 5 factorial 4. Last one is same, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, now this determinant is equal to, we can write factorial 1, factorial 2, factorial 3. Now what is 3 factorial 2? Definitely, if we see, the 3 factorial 2 is equal to factorial 3. Since factorial 3 is equal to 3 factorial 2, so we can apply the reverse property. So 3 factorial 2 is factorial 3. So we write it is factorial 3. Similarly, it is factorial 4, and it is factorial 5. Last one is factorial 2, factorial 3, factorial 4. Okay. We need one operation again, which is switch the R2, row 2 by row 3. Okay. R2 and R3 are switching. So when we apply switching property of two rows, determinant become negative. You know it? Okay. So it is factorial 1, factorial 2, factorial 3. This is the negative determinant. R2 become in R3 and R3 become in R2. So factorial 2, factorial 3, factorial 4. It is factorial 3, factorial 4, and it is factorial 5. Okay. Now we have get the standard determinant which we see in the result. Okay. We know by result the value of this determinant is what? First one, it is negative, and minus 2 into product of element of first row or first column. So minus 2 into product of elements of first row. Okay, so it is simply equal to minus 2 into first row is factorial 1, factorial 2, and factorial 3. Okay, now what is factorial 1? It is simply 1. Factorial 2 is what? It is 2, and factorial 3 is 6. So it is equal to minus 2 into 1 into 2 into 6. So it is minus 24. So the last option, option number D, is the correct option. So by using this result that we discuss today, is very simple and easy to evaluate such type of determinant. Hope it is also useful to you. If you like, please like this video, share to your friend circle, and if you are newer,